Herpetology is the study of reptiles and amphibians. So herps is just a shorter word for all of the different reptiles and amphibians that we have, such as snakes, turtles, lizards, salamanders, and frogs.
Both amphibians and reptiles are ectotherms, meaning that they gain the heat that they need from the outside environment. Amphibians have smooth, moist skin. They lack scales, they lack claws. Whereas reptiles, their two predominant features are they have scales and they have claws.
Amphibians have a very thin skin, and it helps them breathe and absorb moisture. And because of this, they can absorb a lot of chemicals from the environment. And so they are the first ones to show any effects from pollution, and because of that, they're considered indicator species. Amphibians are really important to the environment, partly because they eat a lot of insects, including insect pests like mosquitoes. But they are themselves also a very important food source for other animals, such as birds, mammals, and reptiles.
If you just look at the sheer number of snakes, for example, there's nearly 3,000 species of snakes worldwide. They serve as very important predators in most of our ecosystems. So pest species in the food and agriculture industry, things like Norway rats and black rats. Without snakes as predators in those ecosystems, those rodent populations can go unchecked and cause millions and millions, and perhaps billions of dollars of damage to our food and agricultural crops worldwide.
Herping is the activity of going out and looking for reptiles and amphibians, and there are a lot of different ways to go herping. And if you want to go out and get down and dirty, you can go out and you can flip over rocks and logs.
Another thing that I do with my kids is I oftentimes take them out with a spotting scope that you would use for birding, for example, and you can take them to ponds and lakes, any of those bodies of water that have a lot of logs for basking, and you can really get really great views of some of our 16 species of turtles that we have across the state. But there are a few species that occur fairly commonly and statewide. And so for thinking about snakes, I'll just go back to them first. A common species that most people see are probably eastern garter snakes. With turtles, there's two that people probably are most familiar with, and that's the painted turtle. And if we're talking about land turtles, the box turtle. With respect to some of our amphibians, one of the most common species would probably be the green frog or the bullfrog. Salamanders, probably the most common species is a redback salamander.
It's kind of a couple rules of thumb when you go herping, and one of the big ones is to make sure and put the rock or the log back exactly where you found it. The other rule of thumb is to observe only and never ever handle an endangered species. Programs available if people would like to get out and listen for calling frogs and toads, and one of them is called Frog Watch, and that's basically where you have a pond on your property or maybe a friend's property, and you monitor that pond all year long and you record which species you hear calling or ones you see.
So there's lots of opportunities to learn more about amphibians and reptiles, because I think in general that's the vertebrate class that people know the least about.
And I think getting children and people of all ages out into the wild to see reptiles and amphibians would really help alleviate some of these misconceptions and fears that people have about them, because they really are a very beneficial and interesting animals that we have.